What is a normal map? Normal map is a type of texture map that makes the illusion of depth on the low poly model. As you can see, I have a high poly model on the left side and a low poly model on the right side. If I want this low poly model to look like exactly like this high poly model with all the curvings and hills and valleys, I need to make a normal map from this high poly model on the low poly model. This way, with a fewer number of the polygons, I can have the details of a high poly model on my low poly model. If you look at my high poly model, it consists of 257,000 of faces. It's not ideal for a game or animation at all. And my low poly model is only almost 5,000 faces. Okay, let's start creating our normal map. Let's place the high poly model back to its original place. For creating a normal map for your low poly model, you need two models. One, of course, your low poly model, and another one is the high poly model that has the details that you want on your normal map. Your low poly model should have the UV map. If your model don't have the UV map, I'll show on another video how to create UV map for your models. After creating your UV map, you can bake textures for your low poly model. If I show you, as you can see, this is the UV for my low poly model head. Remember, if you have separate parts on your model, you need to have a low poly and high poly of the same object on the scene. Separating objects helps with creating normal maps and ambient occlusion later down the line. Okay, one last thing before I start creating our normal map is knowing how actually baking the maps works. Imagine you have a high poly and you have another model with a low poly. The render engine, in this case Cycles, tries to project on the negative side of the face normals. It means if your face normals are in this direction, the projection goes the other way. The projection continues until it reaches the faces of the high poly model and take the shape of the high poly model. The problem is when the high poly model penetrates some part of low poly model and actually is above the low poly. In this case, projection fails to identify the high poly model and you will see a green or yellow artifact on your normal map. So we need a low poly that is slightly bigger than our high poly so that when the projection goes to the negative of the face normals, it can capture all the details on the high poly model. And also we don't want to change the size of our low poly model. That's when the cage comes in. We create a cage bigger than our high poly model to capture the details on the maps, and the map actually applies to the original low poly model. To create a cage for our model, select our low poly, press Shift and D to duplicate, right click to stay in place, move it to another collection like cage, rename it, for example, hit cage, then go to the modifiers, add modifier, and add a displace modifier. It's too much. Let's try 0.1, 0.05, 0.005. 0.01 is looking good, almost. We have some artifacts here, but it looks good. The next thing we need to do is going to the render properties, change from EV to cycles, change device from CPU to GPU compute, go down to the bake, in the sampling, lower it down to something like 5, something very, very low. Then go to the bake, change combined to normal, and uncheck the clear image, change the size from 60 pixel to something like 4 pixel, and make sure before baking your normal map, right click on your low poly model and shade is smooth. If you don't shade it smooth, this thing can happen to your normal map. Check the selected to the active, open it up, instead of extrusion and max ray distance, check the cage, click on the eyedrop and select head cage. Okay, now select head high poly first, then control click on the head low poly. It's important that the low poly model should be the second selection. Go to the shading, create a new material for your low poly model, Shift A, texture, image texture, create a new texture, eye limit, normal map, 2K by 2K. Okay, make sure to select this texture before baking. With everything selected, you can click on the bake and make sure that the render for the head high, head low, and the head cage is turning on. Click on the bake and wait for the process to be completed. Hide the high poly head and the cage, go to the texture paint, and as you can see, we have normal map for our low poly model. To see the effects, go to the shading and connect our newly created texture to the base color. As you can see, now we have a normal map. You need to do this process for every single part of your model, every part that is separated, and if you place all parts of your model in a single UV tile, everything should update it in this normal map texture. For example, if I bake the eyes normal map, if I place the eyes UV here, it will update this normal map and the eyes normal map will be here. Okay, and the final touch is tweaking the normal map on the low poly model, there's always some type of artifacts. You need to fix them by hand. To do so, click on the Hello, go to the texture paint, and here click on the smear brush, and from the 3D viewport or 2D viewport, you can fix things around. You can increase or decrease the size of your brush with pressing F and moving your mouse, and fix things by smearing around. Okay, things looking much better now. Okay, that's it for this video. If you like the video, please hit the like and subscribe to the channel. More videos like these tutorials on the Blender, animations, rigging are going to be uploaded soon. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye bye.